And so, all this video is nothing but an intro to Pipewire over Pulse Audio, that I will install for the first time in my life, live on baby woke camera. And I'm warning you, I don't have idea how this will go, but I will start with a PA control info. And that will give me Pulse Audio Server as expected. Okay, next I will install Pipewire Pulse Audio package. And here I see we have lots of options, that I won't even pretend I know what they're for. But I will just proceed with Pulse, and I will leave Jack plugin out for now. Super secure password activated. Poof! What's this crap now? It says Pipewire Pulse conflicts with Pulse Audio package. So maybe retry with allow erasing option? Ooh, life in Fedora. Now it says GNOME shell is a protected package dependent on Pulse Audio, which is a big lie. So I guess I will remove Pulse with RPM after all, and skip the dependencies with the no depths option. Alright, all done. And try again to install Pipewire with DNF. But we don't need the allow erasing flag anymore. Run! Now I can only imagine I could reload all the services, but because I'm totally sure something will go wrong, I will reboot to make sure everything is properly loaded.
Run.
For start, that video player I opened before? It had not sound. So let's see what's wrong this time. Oops! That doesn't look very good. And on a very random guess, I'd say that Pipewire didn't automatically start the services, so I will start from that. I'm gonna open both the service and the socket, and see. By the way, the reason PA control will work, is because Pipewire provides Pulse Audio compatibility libraries, but there isn't a Pulse Audio server running. Just saying if you are confused with that. And finally, we have a Pipewire server that handles our audio. And hopefully it will solve all the long-standing sound issues in Linux once and for all. On the rest video I'm actually testing it. To give you the short version, shell session sounds work, audio in Chrome works, Flatpak apps also work, even the resolve works. Which reminds me that the also part in Pipewire is complete. But there are also quite a lot of bugs, like sound freezes in certain apps. So I wouldn't say it is ready, but if you just want to troll DistroTube, it is possible already. By the way, I recorded this video yesterday, but I only did an actual Pipewire reading today, and I learned many things I didn't know. So I will upload another more technical video with Pipewire at some point. For now, this video only shows how you can test it, although I would strongly advise to use a Fedora Rawhide installation to do that, since that's the distro will get a default Pipewire support first, and all the packages are fully updated. Anyway, that was everything. Coco out.